Welcome, everybody, to another episode of Protect Your Vizion. We're your hosts, Matt Vizzi
and Tim Vizzi.
Today, we're highlighting founder of fitness brand Ampletics, Leon Henderson.
Otherwise known as Cooleon.
From performing on MTV's hit show America's Best Dance Crew,
to performing on the Grammy stage with Pharrell and Kenrick Lamar,
to DJing all over the world.
Along all his success, Leon found himself in the worst shape of his life.
And he knew it was time to apply more pressure. And in just 11 months, he completely transformed his whole body, lost 100 pounds, and competed in a bodybuilding competition.
So without further ado, we introduce Leon Henderson. Pro Vision Sports and Entertainment.
Protect your vision.
So it's a hot day, Burbank, California.
Yeah,
got our boy Cooleon on the show, man. Appreciate you coming on.
For sure. Thank you guys for having me. Appreciate
Absolutely, man. So let's start from the top, man.
Yeah.
I mean, you've been on a journey, and you've done so many things. You're a take action type dude. Mm-hmm. But you actually started out on America's Best Dance Crew.
So basically, I mean, starting from America's Best Dance Crew, I was put together by the producers and a couple friends. And that's when the whole crew phase was like popular and everyone wanted to be in a dance crew, and they basically wanted a heavy group to represent the show, and basically meaning overweight men that could dance and do tricks and whatnot. And so I kind of had that football build, so you know, I kind of worked for the team, you know?
Yeah, yeah.
So we called ourselves a Heavy Impact. We got pretty far in the show. We got to top five.
Okay.
And
and that's one of the biggest shows at that time, man.
At the time, yeah.
America's Best Dance Crew is one of the biggest shows going. Those guys wanna come treat you right, cause you're sweeter than apple pie. Everything that you want, you got. Girl, you know that you need to stop. Always talking about what you got. Always talking about what you got. Girl,
you know that you need to stop. It was crazy because, like, we had, I mean, countless amount of messages on Facebook at the time. Instagram wasn't even popular yet.
Yeah.
We had countless amount of just messages from people all over the world telling us their story and how we inspired them, which is honestly what kept us going for the 3 years that we worked after the show, you know? Mm-hmm. We were like, damn, mm-hmm. we feel like we can touch so many more souls. So we were like, you know, let's move with it. Our mission statement was to, like, anybody can do it. If we can do it as heavy guys in the industry, anybody can do it.
You really are making an impact at that point.
Absolutely.
You know what I mean? Not just on the show, but outside of it.
It's crazy what they were doing, the movesets they were doing. I mean, yeah. They made it to the top five. Which tells
reason.
You how talented
for
these
a
guys
reason.
Are.
Right.
Such a passion for tumbling and flipping is how I propelled my career to get to the next level. I started off doing a movie, and the second job I ever did, I did the circus video with Britney Spears as a tumbler. And then, you know, there was a period of time where I got injured. I had a motorcycle and I went down and I broke my leg. And during that period is when I had a lot of time up here.
Yeah,
right. You know, I found myself in a dark place at times because you go from 100 miles per hour moving all the time and dancing and teaching and sharing your knowledge and tumbling and all those things to being stable for 6 months.
Immobilized.
Being able to move, like, is your career.
Exactly. I mean, you can't pay rent. You can't, you know what I mean? You can't pay your bills. Like, it was hard for me.
That's
it
wild.
Was hard. I started trying to retrain my leg and get better and just strengthen, you know, what I had to strengthen in order to just get back to where I was. And I worked at a bar as a barback. You know, and over time I got tired of it, and which showed in my work ethic, and I got fired. Interestingly enough, one of my best friends called me like 3 days after I got fired, and was like, "Hey, bro, like, are you available to go to Japan next week?" And I was like, "For what?" He's like, "Yo, bro, we're about to, you know, shoot this music video with Will I Am. Mm-hmm. The theme is That Power, and they're gonna go to Japan and shoot this." And I was like, "Wait, what? Like, I just got fired from my job 3 days ago. Like, what are you saying right now?" And he repeated himself, and I was like, "What?" Like, the crazy part is that I felt like I had almost spoken this into existence, because during this period of me getting back on my feet and starting to dance again, I made a video, and it was to the song written by Will.i.am, Oh My God, right? I put that video out, and I was still hurting. I had a brace on my foot. You would never know I was hurt in the video, but I was dancing. I was doing my thing. And then we were on tour with Will.i.am soon after this music video was done, doing promo tour, and then we actually toured. And one of the songs we toured to was Oh My God.
I remember you telling me a story about how Will.i.am actually kind of inspired you totally to kind of go the DJ route.
So when we were on tour with Will.i.am, not only would we do shows, but he always in the nightclubs. He DJed the nightclub. And Dubs was also like one of my mentors when I was on tour as a DJ. He kind of was always talking about it, and Will.i.am was always doing it. And it was just one of those feelings that every time he did it and I saw the way the crowd reacted, I was just like, whoa, like, that's insane. And then one day we're just in the green room and he's talking about it, and I'm just like listening, and I'm like, I can do this. So I was 100% inspired by Will.i.am and DJ Dubs. Shout out to both of you guys. I learned how to DJ on YouTube and with a couple friends that were just giving, you know what I mean? Just wanted to help me and give me knowledge that, you know, this is how you beat match, you know, or this is how you scratch, you know what I mean? And then I found a company called Check 1-2 Entertainment. And once I found them, that's when I really learned how to map and how to really feel and learn a crowd, read a crowd, you know, any crowd. It definitely propelled me for 2-3 years of just consistency in LA, making a name for myself, being able to have different DJing opportunities for celebrities and clubs and events and concerts and artists, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So for me, it created a whole other lane of income,
right,
and a whole another lane of just experience. And, you know, I had Dubs right there on my side, like, yo, dude, like, let's get it. You know what I mean? He's a DJ, a great DJ, and he had toured with many people as well. And like, you know, whenever we were done with Will.i.am and it was just us as friends apart from him, it was like, yo, dude, like, I can see you're taking this seriously. Like, here's a little bit more knowledge, you know? Right. He gave me, he dropped me my first music.
Sheesh.
You know what I mean? In my library that I was able to play for clubs and whatnot. So, you know, you have the right people in your life at the right time helping you, you know what I mean? And assisting you and getting to where you want to go.
Having a support system and having people who are going to be there for you and help you through that growth,
absolutely,
right?
Absolutely.
At the beginning and through the whole process.
Absolutely.
Taking it back to experiences, I mean, you've performed at the Grammys.
Yeah, man.
With Kendrick Lamar and Pharrell.
I'll never forget those experiences, man. That first Grammy performance was all about the Trayvon Martin. You know, we all had black hoodies on, and we all were standing up for what we believed in. Pharrell felt like he needed to make a statement on a big stage, and that he definitely did. It was another, you know, same crew of guys, my boy Fresh, shout out to you. He hit me up, you know, we were all the Will.i.am boys, and he was like, hey bro, like, Pharrell needs steppers, and he wants, you know, male dancers, and, you know, are you available? And I was like, absolutely. That first Grammy experience was unbelievable because we had so much experience together that our chemistry was so strong. Yeah. So it didn't take us long to, like, make Pharrell feel comfortable.
Yeah.
Then fast forward a year later, Kendrick Lamar had basically the same idea, but in his own way. And he's a very, if you pay attention to Kendrick Lamar, he's a very, very, very creative human being. He wanted to really make America, or just whoever was watching, feel what we felt for all these years as black men in America. And the one thing I remember about the Kendrick Lamar performance that affected me, like, internally, in rehearsals, Kendrick ran the show 7 times in a row.
Yeah.
Every single time that man performed that rehearsal, I was standing right in the cage and I was blacked out because it was just his moment, right? He was in that spotlight. And all you see as he's spitting his bars is spit, spit, spit. But I felt every spit because the conviction that came out of him, like, I'm getting goosebumps thinking about it.
Yeah, that gives me goosebumps, right?
The conviction coming out of this man, like, every time he did it, I was inspired.
Like, pure passion. Like, you're witnessing, like, pure passion.
Most real feeling that I've ever felt watching an artist perform.
Wow.
Fast forward to show day, he wanted to pray with everybody. And he said the prayer. Not one time said, let me perform great. He said, let us.
Mm.
And when he said, let us, multiple times, I was like,
I'm ready.
That's powerful.
Let's go.
That's inspiring, just, like, hearing that, like, from a leadership standpoint, even from like just a team standpoint, man, like how important it is to like really bring people together, right? You know what I mean? And like, absolutely, how much more did you want someone to just like just come through for them too?
Oh my gosh.
And that way, you know what I mean? Like after seeing all that, and then like you just want to give the best performance of your life at that point.
And I remember too, I was in the jail cell right before we started shooting, and right before they said 3, 2, 1, go. I remember sitting there and be like, yo, I'm about to be a gorilla in this cage. I might break through this
thing. Fighting the bars off,
Like, and literally, when you watch back the footage, you see me wilding out. Like, just like, I was in the moment. It came off so naturally because of what Kendrick, like, instilled in us. Like, you just wanted to, like,
that
you said,
just fires
you
me
just
up.
Wanted to, like, blow up.
You didn't need to flip the switch or anything. It was already there. You just needed the music to start playing.
Exactly. Like, to me, at that point, it wasn't the Grammys anymore. You know what I mean?
It didn't even matter, right?
At all. It was
whatever
just,
stage
like,
it was, yeah.
Whatever stage it was, I was going to, man, that Kendrick performance, that was my last performance. That was my hoorah as a dancer. That was when I said, if I'm going to go out, this is how I'm going to go out.
You've inspired so many people with your story. It's actually opened up another lane for you. So you went from dancer to DJ. Now you have a full-blown fitness brand.
Yeah, man.
So A.M.P. But it's Ampletics, right?
Ampletics,
that's how you pronounce it?
Ampletics.
A.M.P. because Cooleon always says in his post, follow this dude, first of all, because you'll just be inspired. It's one of he has one of the most inspiring feeds. He's always posting inspirational stuff. But he's always talking about applying more pressure.
Yeah. So that started because, obviously, whenever you lose that amount of weight in that short amount of time, people are like, what? Give me your plan. You know what I mean?
And how did you do it?
Right. How did you do it? And so my inbox, like when I dropped that photo, that before and after photo, my inbox blew up. And I was just willing and I was giving. And I was like, yo, you want?
Yeah.
This is what I did. Boom. Boom. I can't even begin to tell you how many insecurities I had. I would never take off my shirt at a pool. I would never go to the beach with my girl because her friends were all gonna be there and I didn't wanna look like a fat dude or whatever. You know, anytime anything outdoor related, I was the guy showing up at the pool fully clothed with sneakers on, you know? Yeah. Now, you can't even tell me twice. You know what I'm saying?
Give me a reason to take my shirt off.
Give me a reason to take off my shirt. Yeah. But honestly, what I was learning about myself was that, yo, I can handle anything.
Mm-hmm.
So Fernando from E Naked LA, he referred me to my coach that I hired, Miguel. And Miguel helped me get through a whole prep for this men's physique competition. Mm. I did a 20-week prep with him. It was my first time ever doing something that extreme.
Yeah.
I placed top five, I was fourth. But I learned a lot about my body, one, and I learned a lot about my mind, too. I was pushed. When you're at your weakest, when you're depleted of all carbs, and you have nothing in you, and you still gotta do an hour of cardio on the Stairmaster, AKA slow roast, you're not just dealing with that moment of cardio and that feeling of just weakness, you're also dealing with all your outside, you know, jobs or whatever other stresses you had. All I would think about during those times was, you got this, bro, apply pressure. Then it became, apply more pressure. Like, give me all the pressure. Actually, this week, I'm gonna level up. Let's go one step higher on the Stairmaster. Let's go, instead of 6, let's go 7. Instead of 7, let's go 8. Like, I just kept challenging myself to the point where I put a big medicine ball on my shoulder and just started walking the Stairmaster. Because I was like, if I'm going to feel some type
of pressure,
give it to me.
Yeah.
I can handle it and I'll get it done in a professional manner.
Let's go.
You know, outside of the gym and inside of the gym.
Yeah. Yeah.
And this was 5 weeks out from my competition. This is 15 weeks of prepping and then 5 weeks out deciding to turn it up even a bigger notch.
Yeah.
Like, it was just like one of those things where I put my mind in a place and I never left that place.
Man.
What comes out of that is, even after the competition, is that you're able to carry those disciplines and that foundation through life.
Yeah.
And it's such a different thing. It's such a different, like, level of a character. You know what I mean? Of a character that you have inside of you. Like, of the character that you carry throughout your everyday life. You start to build you.
How do you protect your vision, man?
Man, I protect my vision by continuing to keep my motivation for myself out there.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Continue to tell people to apply more pressure. Continue to tell people, yo, look, this is what's right. This is what's wrong. You know what I mean? And continue to transform everybody, literally, every human one at a time. You know what I mean? And I really want to make people understand this lifestyle. I'm a firm believer that health is like the way this world's gonna change. I've had a few clients, overweight clients, they reach out to me and I'll wake up to an essay and I'm like, what is happening? Like, what is something wrong? I'll read it and it's them thanking me. Like, I went to the doctor today. They said my blood pressure is right where it should be. They said I don't need to take blood pressure medicine anymore. I'm able to like just live.
Yeah.
And I just wanna say thank you, man. Like, you not only helped me lose 50 pounds, but I'm able to like live a better life because of this.
Absolutely.
And those messages changed my whole life. When I see the happiness just like come off of my clients, of like how happy they are when they're finally at that finish line of I'm healthy and I understand how to live a healthier lifestyle, you see the difference from when you started to when they finished.
Yeah.
Like, you see all the things that they tell you, all the things that's wrong, and then at the end they tell you all the things that are right. And all that does is, again, domino effects to the next person. And the more we can get that across to the people in our country, like, I feel like it's gonna change our country. You know, like, I have a client that he was one of my old, I used to mentor him when I started as in Heavy Impact Crew. And he was a dancer, his name is Manny. He's a comedian now. And I remember he hit me up, and he was like, yo, bro, like, how do you just, like, you know, follow your dreams? Like, how do you just drop everything and just do it? And I was like, bro, if you believe in yourself, and you really believe in that you have talent, and you really believe you can go far with it, I was like, what are you waiting for?
Yeah.
And so, from that moment, he literally, I see him, he goes to work, and then I see a flyer. Comedian Manny at so-and-so. Comedian Manny over here. And then, a few weeks ago, I actually went to one of his shows, and dude is mad funny.
Yeah.
And I was the whole time I'm thinking, I'm like, I remember this conversation between he and I, and I'm like, bro, you did this. You took it serious, and not just took your career in comedy serious, but you took this weight loss serious. Mm-hmm. He's lost, I want to say, over 60 now, at least. He's one of my main dudes that always pushes apply more pressure, always pushes the slow roast because he believes in it, because he's doing it.
Yeah,
he's acting. He's able to run around with his kid now comfortably. You know what I mean? And it's like, you're setting the example for your kid now.
Wow. It's so funny, too, how it comes full circle, how you started off as a heavy guy in a group, and your name was called Heavy Impact.
Yeah, man.
And now the impact you're making isn't something light, something small. It's something major.
It's
definitely
something major, man. I had the vision, though. I had the vision, you know what I'm saying? From day one. You may not know it, but you may have this thing in your mind, this vision in your mind from day one. But that thing, that vision, over time, it's like an avalanche. It just keeps growing and growing and growing and growing. And then one day, it's just like, boom, like, oh, that's what I'm supposed to do.
Right.
Oh, that's what I've been working so hard for. Oh, look at me now. You know what I mean? Like, your vision, don't ever take your vision for granted.
Protect your vision.
Always protect your vision.
Always protect your vision.
So many people are just like sitting on the couch probably right now watching YouTube and watching this video and just being like, damn, I'm inspired. I want to do this. But do it. You know what I mean? Like, don't just be inspired. Like, take that inspiration and turn it into action.
Yes.
Once you turn it into action, create a discipline by doing it daily. Take it day by day. Now, the days that get hard where you're at home and you're maybe hanging out and you're just watching a show and you're tired and you didn't go to the gym, those are the days that count the most. Because I found myself in that situation multiple times. I found myself in a situation where, man, I got home from a long day of work and I'm at home and I'm tired. I'm like, yo, I have not done cardio or worked out. And I'm like, I do not want to go to the gym. But your mind creates a discipline and you click. When that click happens, just do it. I'm tired, I'm weak, but I'm going.
I'm fired up right now.
Hey,
I feel like applying more pressure.
Let's go.
Can we go apply more pressure right now?
Let's go do it. I'm with it. I'm with it.
Let's go. Supply more pressure. Let's get it.
I'm just doing what I gotta do.